morning, everyone. I'm glad you're here. Thank you very much for joining me. Figured I'd keep a closer eye on what's going on at Yellowstone. Here we got a view from the old faithful webcam looking there around the upper geyser basin. This here is Firehole River. And you can see, it's letting off steam, releasing pressure, and it looks a little dirty. Mostly down here at the fire hall and up over here. It's currently 10 degrees there. I don't know what the wind chill is, but you can see different areas where the ground has heated up and melted the snow, and this has been ongoing. Back over here, this is the Mallard Lake Resurgent Dome. Two resurgent domes there at Yellowstone. Most volcanoes only have one. But Yellowstone has two. And there was a recent earthquake that I downloaded the data. It looks like it's trying to snow there, don't it? Once in a while, I'll see a little snowflake go by. Today is January 5th, 2023. So on the left here, I have Madison River. And next to that is Maple Creek. Let me pull this over and see that earthquake. Actually, it comes in right there. Okay. And then to the far right, we got West Thumb, or Little West Thumb, as I like to call it. Let me go over here and see if I can get this better. Okay. So this earthquake here at Madison River looks like it's the largest. Remember, Madison River area is the location where when Yellowstone decided to unzip with its last major eruption, it started there. There has been at least 40 smaller eruptions since the last major eruption. There we have the spectrogram. USGS is not reporting this earthquake. So let me take a look here. Let's see, it looks like maybe right there. So it comes in as a magnitude 2.07. And as you know, years ago, Hank Hessler, I believe it was saying that when Yellowstone started having magnitude 2 earthquakes, they would be very concerned. Magnitude 2s in the past were really rare, and now they're getting more and more common. In my last report, I talked about how the ground was getting brittle because of the pressure of the magma coming up. And that is why lately we've been seeing more and more steam being released. As the magma comes up, it heats the water. And yeah, they say that is good, that it's releasing the pressure. There is a cap of rhyolite over the top, keeping the magma under the ground. But it's still heating the water. And when you see it dark like this, you know it's up over 2,000 degrees Fahrenheit to melt the rock to bring it up with the steam. And you can see the color of the snow and the steam and see that there is a lot of material coming up with that heated water. So it looks like this earthquake here is mostly volcanic tremors. Yeah, shallow volcanic tremors. They're generally about 3 kilometers below sea level for volcanic tremors. And let's go back. Let's take a look at this. What is this? What do we got going on here? All right, let me pull that. Yeah, more volcanic tremors and, popping of the ground. The ground getting more brittle, cracking the ground. And let me close this. They actually call this blobs of magma. All right. Yeah, fairly shallow. This here is showing the heated water. We got another small earthquake right there. And this is what it was showing when I pulled the files. Again, this is the Madison River area. It is good that I am not seeing the melt, lines of melt like I have before. So that is good. Okay, we'll take a look over here and take a look at the Yeah, the seismic signature. I don't know why it's so big. Let me close this and try this again. Yeah, I don't know why it's doing that. All right, so here's the earthquake as it came in at Maple Creek. Let's look at the spectrogram. Wow. Yeah, that is a wow moment. Yeah, you can see the magma that came up and the heated water and gases. They have a separate earthquake marked right there. That would be a magnitude 1.63. And we got another one marked in red. When it's marked in red, it means the computer picked up the earthquake and sent a message to the geologist. So this one here is 1.65. They moved the camera again so you can see the coloring of the snow and the coloring of the steam. Yeah. And different areas where the ground is heated enough to melt the snow. Here you can see that there is no earthquakes reported as of yet. Now this is as 9:49 a.m. Central Daylight Time. Therefore, the Yellowstone area. Let me bring it in a little bit. And I'll change it to the last 7 days. Okay, we got 10. Yeah, mostly up here in the Yellowstone area than the other ones. I reported on that one down by the Wasatch Fault. Let's zoom in over here. Yeah, the last one they reported was on the 3rd, a 0.2, a 1.2, 5.2 miles, 3.2 miles, a 0.4, let's see, a 1.2, a 0.5, a 1.0, and a 0.9. So this one marked in red, they have not reported. Did I do this one? I don't know. I don't think so. Let's see, 1:39 Universal Time. Let's go there. Magnitude 1.73. We got two more up here marked in red. Let's see, 9:31. Let's look at the seismic signature. Okay, probably about there. Let's double check with the spectrogram. That comes in as a magnitude 1.50. And this one here, also not being reported. Let's take a look at its signature. Probably about there. 1.24. This is what it's currently showing down here at the bottom. We have West Thumb. This is Madison River. And then up here at the top is Maple Creek. They moved the camera again. We're looking at Old Faithful. A little dirty, not too bad. I've seen it worse. And you can see the areas where the snow has melted. There's also some places back up over here. Once in a while you can see steam in there, there, and over there. I'll give you a link to this paper. It's on New Scientist and where it talks about the melt. They found the reserve is composed of, here it says 16 to 20% melted rock on average, compared with a previous estimate of 9%. Well, actually, they said before it was between 3 and 5%. Depending on assumptions made about the shape of the spaces between the solid crystals. This suggests that the reservoir contains about 1,600 cubic kilometers of melted rock, or almost twice as much as previous estimates of roughly 900 cubic kilometers. Eruptions are supplied with magma from two huge reservoirs beneath the caldera, one near the mantle and one a few kilometers below the surface, about 3. Though once thought of merely as big tanks of magma. The reservoirs contain complex crystal mush of melted rock and crystals, says the one scientist at the University of Illinois Urban Campaign. The compensation of this mush partly determines the volcano's likelihood of erupting. A higher proportion of melted rock to solid crystal would make the magma more likely to mobilize. Oh, and I love how they just changed the estimates of how much melt they need. Before, they figured about 30% melt, but it says here, even at the higher end of their estimate, Magmeyer says the proportion of melted rock is still well below the 35 to 50% threshold needed for an eruption. Yellowstone can spend a large amount of its life cycle with some melt without eruptions, he says. Carrie Cooper at the University of California, Davis, wrote a commentary on the research, says, depending on how the melted rock is distributed, there could be enough for a small eruption. But this work shows there, it's definitely not enough there for a catastrophic eruption. Well, they could have a small eruption. Doesn't rule that out. So now they're saying for Yellowstone to erupt, it would need to be 50 to 65% melt. You know, the data keeps changing. And that's because research keeps improving. But as you know, any volcano can erupt with little or no warning. So that's all I have for you right now. If you have any thoughts or comments or questions, please put it down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Always be prepared. Remember, the government is not going to come and save your butt for many disasters. There's just not enough emergency services out there to help a large amount of people. In, you know, look at Buffalo. Look at Buffalo, New York. Look at what happened there in Northern California. They just did not have the personnel. So you should be prepared on your own for any type of disaster. Thank you again for watching. Thank you very much for your support. As always, please stay safe, and you stay safe by being prepared. And I'll talk to you later. God bless you. Bye.